there's a reason why you are at every book launch. You're my lucky mascot. I've almost now become superstitious about it. And I was telling my mom that it's like Ganpati. Every book launch, I put you on this dais, and then I do your visarjan the next day. And I think when Vidya and I were sitting backstage, I also said that if you pop it, I'm going to have your picture at my, you know, 12th or 15th book launch. Because that's the amount of faith I have in you.
Just make sure you're wearing the right clothes when that happens, because you will be judged.
Oh my God.
And make sure it doesn't look like the D-Decor Fabric Air couch. I've just done some endorsements.
Simone is here and she's taken grave offense at this D-Decor fabric.
I'm actually promoting it. I've even done it on my show. But listen, it's an absolute pleasure and honor to interview you because, you know.
Chand.
Yeah, I mean, I have to say these things. It's your launch. I have to be nice to you. Conversations with you are like welcome to paradise anyway.
You don't know if you're in hell or you're in heaven, and you just...
That's pretty much sounds like most people's marriages.
That's also true.
But Welcome to Paradise is now touted to be a juggernaut success. It is so different from everything you've done. We'll get to that later. But first things first, something I'm genuinely curious about. You went back to school. What prompted you? What made this happen? What was the experience like?
I think I partly went back to university because I was approaching 50. And I've always said this, that age is definitely a mathematical problem, but it is not a sum of division where you're reduced to what, you know, a fraction of what you were. It could be a multiplication sum if you grow. Now,
I have no understanding of what you just said. Math was not my strong suit, but like,
That's a big lie, because you told me that you were a school topper. It's just that you don't look like any sort of topper. You look like a bottom. But no, sorry. We can't make that joke.
You just made it.
I didn't make it. I stopped.
Go back to the sum of some parts that you were talking about. I don't know what it meant, but anyway.
It meant that you have to keep growing. And at this age, as you're very well aware, the easiest way is to grow horizontally. Yeah. So I'm trying to grow in different ways and not just horizontally.
All right.
Abaya, samajh mein?
Bilkul aa gaya.
Achha, theek hai.
So, iska ye matlab tha ki you wanted to kind of expand your repertoire of knowledge, information, and spread all of that after you're done.
That was even more boring than what I was originally saying.
Okay.
But okay, let's go on.
Yes, sir. But the thing is, what you're not telling us, and what I will share with everyone here, is that you beat the ass out of everyone there. Like, you did so fantastic. You were distinction, superior distinction, whatever they call it. You were the topper. You were the school topper there.
Exceptional distinction is what
Exceptional distinction. Yes, that also happened. But do you feel it enriched you as an author?
No, but I definitely think that you've been casting all the wrong people in Student of the Year. You should have cast me. I'm the Student of the Year. And you just keep taking all these random people and making them.
You fit the tag. You are also from the school of nepotism.
Of course.
Very happily, you actually tick so many boxes. And let's not go back to the time when I did try and cast you and was rejected very heartbreakingly. But anyway, you paved the way.
Can we go back to the time when actually you were in love with me because my testosterone was 11 and I thought I was a man. I didn't have a penis, but I've always had the balls and you were in love with me. Can we go back to that bit?
I can see Shabana ji dwindling in her seat into like shock, despair and horror. And not just that, next to her is a very worried Vidya and an absolutely traumatized Kiara.
No, Kiara is traumatized.
Yes.
I had to change the passage for her this morning because she said, this is very controversial, I can't read this.
But Kiara's controversial meter is really quite low. I wonder if many things shock and surprise her. The book, the four chapters and one novella. I have to say this, this is exceptional writing. And I'm not just saying it because I'm a friend. It's exceptional writing.
You are saying it because you're my friend.
Yeah, but
also because you based Rocky Rani apparently on my marriage. That's what everyone is saying. I don't know. Is that true?
No.
How much can you leech off me, man?
Yeah. Well, it was two people coming together who come from different schools of thought. That doesn't mean it's your marriage, Tina. And everything is not about you.
It was in the press.
Well, that's
you
okay.
Gave an interview. I didn't say these things.
Don't go by what I say. So here's what I'm talking about. There is, of course, you've touched upon so many themes. Thematically, it is dark, of course. It's heartbreaking, very heartbreaking. It deals with death in a way that I haven't really seen. Yet there is so much humor and dark humor laced right through it. I also feel like it's very internal, because you've gone very deeply internal. You've gone back to your childhood. There's a lot of references, or rather inspiration from your nani, her Islamic side, and Ismaili side, sorry. And there's also a lot of very, very, very wonderfully and deliciously written eccentric women. You know, all of them of a certain age, all of them eccentric, breaking every myth, stereotype of what we read of women of a certain age. All of this in four short stories and one novella, I mean, it's no mean achievement. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. That's very kind. Thank you.
So we'll go back to the fact that this big diversion, this creative diversion that you took from your last book, you know, about fitting into that, about the comfortable pajamas, this is a totally different leap that you've taken. And was that also a conscious decision, or is it just part of the evolution of an author?
No, if I'm honest, I think in my last book, I made a lot of compromises. I was under a lot of pressure, internal pressure, external pressure. You're Mrs. Funny Bones, there has to be a joke on every page. My protagonists were originally 60. I had to make them, you know, like 30. So I felt that I had, you know, done a disservice to myself. And then in this book, I was very clear that there are jokes, but only if they service the story. And there are all these amazing women, and I'm fascinated by older women. It's there is a certain richness and a texture in their stories that younger people, well, most younger people may not have. But the way that the world looks at them, it's like the minute you start putting on a hearing aid, everybody else around you becomes deaf, because that's the way it is. Nobody really wants to hear older people. And I know that you're a big advocate of youth. We have discussed this, that how do you stay relevant? No, really, don't make that face. I'm not saying anything bad. You said it was by immersing yourself, you know, amongst young people, which is why you love, you know, Shanaya and Anaya and Kiara and Alia, which is great.
She's Ananya.
Okay, Ananya also. You know Anaya's also. But I think that... But I think that every phase is interesting.
I don't know why I come year after year.
No, but it's a good thing.
I don't know why I bother.
We had a very long conversation. We were talking about some directors, which we can't name. And he said that, you know, those are obsolete. They are fossils and all these awful things about them. And then and then he said, you know, you have to be relevant. And that's why I hang around with young people. And I said, yeah, I just don't like people. So I can't hang around with young people. So I'll go and study. But that was, because we are fossils now, we are 50, the world that we grew up in doesn't exist, so how do we stay fresh and reinvent ourselves? You've chosen, you know, the fountain of youth, and like a vampire, you suck all the blood, all these young people, and I've tried a more sedate approach.
So basically what we've deduced from this is that In Conversation is a wannabe young mind, and I'm talking to a prolific evolved mind. Basically, that is what our deduction is from this particular answer. And I'm very grateful that I've been invited to kind of ask you questions, and I'll go back with an exceptionally low self-esteem tonight. But that's fine. I've combated trolls. You're nothing.
I'm nothing.
Yeah.
And I love you. And this is all coming from how much I love you.
But before
I love everything about you. I love this Gucci suit.
And you love the sound of your own voice.
No,
one second.
But I love you.
I want to kind of special mention to Jaguda. I hope he's in the room here. Jaguda. Jaguda, we love you. We always have and always will. And Jaguda, I hope you know that you have a special mention in the book. Yes, and there's a beautiful mention in one of the short stories. And we just wanted to say that to you with all our love and all our